Here we are at the north end of Takapuna Beach on Auckland's North Shore. We're standing here on the edge of a car park that was built over a reef here in the 1970s. Since then, we've been able to look at the rest of the reef and suddenly realise that the reef is in fact a national treasure. It's the only example of a fossil forest that's been fossilised and in part engulfed by a lava flow that came from Pupuki Volcano, which erupted about 200,000 years ago, and the flows came down through here. So how did we have a forest here? It's because 200,000 years ago, the sea level was a lot lower during the colder periods of the Ice Ages. And so there were forests growing here and on the slopes of the Waitemata Valley, which flowed out underneath Rangitoto Island there during every time of cold Ice Age period when sea level was lower. So let's go and have a look at this fossil forest. So here we are coming down onto the reef, and we've got some of the remains of the lava that came down from Pupuki and flowed around the base of these standing trees that were here. And as it went around the tree wood was cold and cooled the lava, and the lava congealed and solidified around it. You can actually see the layers of gas bubbles captured within that lava. But before the whole lava flow here had cooled and solidified in place, the rest of the molten lava flowed off and on down the slope. And so it left the standing mould around this tree that had been set on fire. And the tree would be burning, and eventually it all incinerated, and it's left this empty hole that we see inside the tree mould. Now, if we look over here at the rest of the reef, all of a sudden you can see dozens of tree moulds like this. In fact, there's over 500 of them have been mapped just on this piece of reef here. So while that hot lava was cooling around the base of all these standing trees, it also cooled on top in contact with the air. So this is the crust of solid lava that cooled on top of the molten lava, which was still underneath, before that rest of the molten lava flowed away. So we've got portions of the crusted over roof still left here at the reef as well. So here we've got two tree molds, one there, and then that molten lava that was still under here has flowed away, and we've been left with this wonderful natural arch, miniature natural arch here, with the roof held up by the two tree moulds. So one of the reasons why this fossil forest is so nationally important is that it's so well preserved. In fact, if you look at it, it's so fresh and well preserved, it almost looks as if it was formed yesterday. But in fact, we know it erupted 200,000 years ago. So how come it looks so fresh? If it's been sitting here on the surface for that long, it would have weathered away. What's happened actually is it's been preserved underneath layer upon layer of volcanic ash that was later erupted from Pupuki. Possibly 5 to 10 meters of ash was above us here. And that for 190,000 years was sitting here protecting this lava flow and fossil forest with all its little features. If we look around, we can see some of that ash here, but most of it's been eroded off by the sea just in the last 6 to 7,000 years. And because that ash is a lot softer than the basalt lava, the sea's come along and it's eroded out the ash. And so it's exhumed the fossil forest and the lava flow surface that we see here, and it's so fresh today. Oh, look what we've got here. Looks like a big canoe actually. With lava cooled on either side of it. And clearly, it's in fact the mould of the large, straight trunk of a tree. It's straight, it's not branching. So we think that this was probably the trunk of a kauri tree. And look, it's a good metre, 1.2 metres across diameter, which is the sort of diameter we might expect with a middle-aged kauri tree. And it goes off here in both directions, over 10 metres long. So imagine that lovely tree standing up here before that lava flow came down, knocked it over, and then has captured its shape in that molten lava. Let's have a look down here. We've got these curved, ropey structures. These are typical pahoehoe that formed on the skin of a lava flow that would have been moving in this direction away from the volcanic centre over here. So sometimes we have moulds of the trunks in situ or as fallen into the lava, but here we've actually got the mould of a branch, and the lava has captured its shape as it's cooling before the branch has incinerated away. Here we can see the branch is curved and then it branches out to a number of little side branches here. In fact, the one comes out through here. If I put my hand in, there we are, that's the side branch there that's been captured by that molten lava. And we can see the shape of the branching upper part of this particular tree. So now we've just moved a little bit further along. Up beside us here, we can see there's quite a small cave and it doesn't go on any further. So it looks like it's just a distinct and discrete cave. And these are usually formed by gas. So that we said there's a lot of gas coming out of the lava as it's moving along and then sitting here. And that gas bubbles all congeal together to create a big gas bubble. And it pushes up the skin or upper crust of the lava flow to create a blister. So this is probably a gas blister underneath the cooled crust of the lava flow that was formed as the lava flow was cooling. So we're getting a mix of the moulds and the blisters in this instance. Is that a blister? It's the shape of a blister. Or is it in fact the mould of a log that was still plastic when some more lava came over it and maybe has squashed it down? So originally it was cylindrical and it's been squashed down and created this shape. And it's the mould of another of these giant kauri tree trunks that were standing up here when the lava flow came up around it and captured it. I hope you've enjoyed what we've been looking at here in the fossil forest and in the lava flows along this section of coast. There's still a lot more to see here, so come along and explore it yourself. See what you can find and interpret, and have a great day next time you'll come here.